Hello students, my name is Bhavna Singh. I am working as an assistant professor in St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management. This is an online tutorial series on e-commerce. So let's begin today's session. Students, we will start with unit 1 today and we will discuss about introduction of electronic commerce, various types of electronic commerce, advantages and challenges of e-commerce, what is the scope of e-commerce, and what is the difference between traditional commerce and electronic commerce. So let's start with the definition of e-commerce. This is a very popular term and you all must be aware of it, because nowadays everybody is using internet and everybody is purchasing or selling anything online. So you people are already engaged in e-commerce. That means when you either buy or sell anything or any goods or any services with the help of internet, that means you are doing e-commerce business. So e-commerce means buying or selling anything using internet is known as e-commerce. Students, e-commerce has made our life very comfortable and very convenient, because nowadays you don't have to go to market to buy a single item. You can simply place an order online and it will be at your doorstep in a while. Because of this convenience and simplicity, online businesses are growing so rapidly. And everything like clothes, food, medical help, household amenities, all these things are easily available online. And that is why today e-commerce has become one of the most popular means of business. E-commerce refers to the paperless exchange of business information, because all the things we are doing online using these four terms, that is electronic data interchange, which includes EFT and EDI. EFT means electronic fund transfer. That means we are doing the monetary transactions online. And EDI means exchange of digital information between various individuals as well as the organizations. And these digital informations can be related to your product details, or you can say your invoice generated or stock available. So all these things comes under electronic document interchange. The next one is we can do the electronic messages using email and fax. Then the next one is electronic bulletin boards. That means we are marketing about the, or we are advertising about the products, or we are providing the customer support, sales, electronic publishing. And the next one is EFT. EFT stands for electronic fund transfer. That means we are doing the payment electronically or with the help of internet using plastic money. Plastic money like credit cards, debit cards, smart cards, all these comes under plastic money. So all these things, they constitute together to form a e-commerce. These are the features of e-commerce. The first one is non-cash payment, which means that you can apply the cashless scheme also. Cashless means we can use credit cards, your debit cards, your smart cards, or you can use EFT, that is electronic fund transfer, via your bank's website and various other modes to do the online payment. Second one is 24/7 service availability. That means it is not time bounded. It is available anytime and anywhere. And an online store remains open 7 days a week, 24 hours of the day. So you can buy anything at any time. Then third one is it helps us in better marketing, or you can say better advertisements of products and services of the business. It increases the reach of advertisements of products and services of business. Next, it helps in improved sales, because a person can order for a product anytime and without any human intervention. So it gives a big boost to the sales. Next, it also helps in maintaining and reporting an inventory status. E-commerce automates inventory management and reports can get generated instantly when we require them. So in that case, the inventory management becomes very efficient and easy to maintain. Then the next one is customer support. Customer support means e-commerce provides us ways to provide pre-sales and post-sales support. That means in pre-sales, it provides us the details about the product, and in post-sales, it assists us to give the feedbacks about the product so as to provide better services to the customers. Now we will discuss the advantages of e-commerce one by one. The first one is cost effective, which means that it is not that much expensive, because an online store, it needs a lower setup and running cost, and since you don't have to need any sales staff or any physical space like a physical store, so thus you saves a lot of money in that. and that save money you can deploy to your services, or you can use them to improve your services and to maintain your product storage, or you can say your warehouse. So thus, this is a very huge advantage for your business as compared to the offline stores. Another advantage is scalability. That means you can serve as many people as comes to your website, unlike your physical store, in which there the number of customers are limited at one time. So therefore, scalability depends on your server, but you know, you can increase it according to your usage. Next is global reach. An online store is available for everyone, regardless of their location. Unlike a physical store which always have the limitation of the geographical area. So those who live in nearby areas, that they will come and shop from the store, but it might not be suitable for the people who shop or who live across from far from the store. But an online store is available every time for everyone. So this is certainly one of the major benefits that you can have from your local to the global customer base, and that too with no additional charges. Then the next one is round the clock availability, which means that it is available 24/7. That means an online store, it remains open for 24 hours of the day, 7 days a week, and you can run your e-commerce business easily regardless of the weather conditions or any time boundation or any location specific difficulties also. So people prefer this because they can shop online anytime and from anywhere. Next is, it provides better customer service. That means many companies, they offer phone support, or you can say social media supports, or email or live chat, text support, so that a customer can share their reviews about the products and their companies. And the last one is, it saves a lot of time on purchasing, and you can do other things without leaving your workplace. And a customer can inquire about a product or service and places anytime, anywhere, from any location. So along with advantages, there might be many challenges that you people have to face while establishing your online store. So the first one is learning curve. That means if you are having your own e-commerce website, then you should have that knowledge to manage it, and you should have that much skills to operate on it and to establish a customer relationship. So it is very much essential for you to learn the technology at least sufficient enough so that you can handle your websites. So having having knowledge and learning skills is very much important in this. And the next one is network issues. That means sometimes it is possible that you have to face some problems due to network reliability, such as long response time due to increased network traffic, or you can say increased bandwidth, and sometimes some accidental problems, or you can say natural disaster problems like floods or earthquakes, they can affect the communication lines also. So like this, network issue is also one of the main obstacle in e-commerce. Next one is growing competition. Nowadays there is a huge competition online, and in order to stand out of the crowd, you need to offer something extraordinary or something that others are not offering. That is differentiating your e-commerce business from the other one. It can be a little bit challenging for you because there is a large amount of competition nowadays, and you have many competitors, so you have to give some extra benefits to your customers so that more and more customers are attracted to your e-commerce business. Next one is lack of security. So security is a major concern in the e-commerce, and payment by credit card or debit card, it requires a trust in the system security, and many of the customers, they are worried about giving their credit cards or debit card details to the websites or to the vendors because of these security issues only. So to build a trust has become one of the most challenges for the e-commerce persons or for the e-commerce business. Then the next one is data protection and integrity. We have to protect our computer, or you can say our websites, from the viruses, because these viruses, they can cause unnecessary delays, or you can say the storage problems or backup of the files. So we have to take care of the protection also. And there is always a danger of hackers. They can hack our files and they can corrupt our online business, or you can say online accounts. Now these are the main categories of e-commerce, that is business to business, business to consumer, consumer to consumer, and consumer to business. And we will discuss about each one of them in detail one by one. The first category is B2B model, which is also known as business to business model. That means the trading or the transactions is occurring between two organizations. In this model, one company sells its products to another company, which is then further sells its products to the final customers. For example, a supplier, it is supplying raw materials to the manufacturing industry, and that manufacturing industry, after producing the product, it is distributing it to the final customers. So the concept is very simple. That is, one company, it has to purchase every small thing from another company to complete its full business setup. As you can see from this diagram also, in this diagram, a wholesaler, it places an order from the website of a business organization, and after receiving that order, it is selling it to the retailers, who is the final customers. So in this way, the transaction or the e-commerce transaction, it is happening between the wholesaler and the retailers. Then the next category is business to consumer. That means the consumer is directly contacting the organizations, or it is directly placing an order from the company's website. In this, no intermediate buyer is there, and the company is directly selling its products to the customer. You can see from the diagram also, the customer, it directly places an order from the websites of the company, and then receiving the product directly from that website only. For example, Flipkart, Amazon, you people are using these kinds of online websites. And what happens in this, a customer can view the products which is shown on the website, and then it chooses a product and order the same. The website will then send a notification to the organization via email, or you can say the messages, and then the organization, it will dispatch the products or the services directly to the customers without any intermediate buyer. So in this, the transaction is happening between the business and the customers, not between two businesses. Then the next category is consumer to consumer, that is C2C business. This type of business is occurring between two customers only. That means one customer wants to sell their assets or products, and the other one wants to buy from that. So if one customer wants to sell their products, they can publish the information, or they can place the advertisements on the particular website like OLX, and the second one who wants to buy, they can view the website and or they can view the advertisements on the website, and then they can contact with each other directly. So after seeing the post on website, they can both the customers, they can directly contact each other, share the details about the products, etc. And then after finalizing, the one customer, it sells its product, and the second one, pays the money for that product. So in this way, the transaction is occurring between the two customers. Some websites, they may charge the consumer for its services, but some may not. It depends upon website to website. Then the next one is consumer to business, that is C2B. In this business, one consumer, it makes their product and services available online for the companies, or you can say organizations, to bid on and purchase, along with the estimates or the amount that he or she wants to spend for that particular service. And the business organizations that fulfill the consumer's requirements within that specified budget, which is specified by the customer, they approaches that customer and then provides its services. So this is basically occurring between the consumers and the business. Consumer is using the organization site for utilizing a particular services. Now we will discuss about the scope of e-commerce. See, the scope of e-commerce is very vast, or you can say very bright, because all of us prefer e-commerce. Why? Because it is very convenient and comfortable for all of us. And nowadays we can get anything from anywhere by sitting at home and just placing an order online. And we don't have to go anywhere. And many of the companies, whether they are buyers or sellers, they are completely relying on these internet technologies, or you can say e-commerce applications, to accomplish their service processing, marketing, advertisements, transactions, products deliveries. And these basic categories like B2C, B2B and C2C, they are attracting more and more companies for participation in e-commerce trading. So in this way, we can say that the potential or the scope of e-commerce is very vast, and it is very enormous and growing very rapidly, because in this age, of e-commerce, everything, like from smallest to bigger, everything is available online. And we can use electronic markets or EDI, that is electronic data interchange, for regular and standard transactions between the organizations. So the first one is accounting, like financial accounting or financial planning and asset management. These are very much become convenient in e-commerce. In commercial transactions also, the scope is very vast, because ordering, delivering and payment of products can be done in a very comfortable or easy way. Then the third one is e-commerce is technology enabled, because we can do all the transactions using these internet technologies. For example, we use web browsers for the customer interfaces, and because of these web browsers only, the customers can directly interact with the websites and they can trade online. Then the next one is exchange of digitized information, which means that the information is transferring or getting exchanged between two organizations or between organization and individual regarding the transmission of electronic orders or regarding the flow of goods and services, regarding payment. So all these things are getting exchanged between the organizations or between the individuals. Then next one, it also helps to interface with customers, because it helps in gathering information from the customers and we can build an effective customer relationship management with the customers. So these were the fields where e-commerce has emerged as an effective technology for all of us. Now let us understand the difference between traditional commerce and e-commerce. First of all, traditional commerce is an ancient way of doing trade, you know, of doing commerce, where we do not use any digital mode. But e-commerce, it is a modern way of doing transactions, and we use a digital mode, like we use electronic payment system, or we do online transactions of orders. Secondly, processing of transactions is manual in traditional commerce, but it is automatic in case of e-commerce. Third, time boundation is there in traditional commerce. It is accessible within a limited time only, but in case of e-commerce, you can shop any time, that is, it is available 24/7 hours. And we can inspect about the goods physically before purchasing them, but in case of e-commerce, the goods cannot be physically inspected because we are ordering them online. And a traditional commerce, it is confined to a particular scope only, it is confined to a particular area only, but e-commerce, it is available globally, that is, it has a worldwide reach. So traditional commerce is the oldest method, and it is done by almost all of their people in their daily life. Like, they walk into the store, they pick out an item and buy it, and then after doing it the payment for that product, they get it back home. But in case of e-commerce, which means electronic commerce, all the things you are going electronically, all the things you are doing online, you don't need to go anywhere for the exchange of goods or the products, and you can do all these things online with the use of internet and with the comfort of sitting just at home and clicking or placing an order. Another thing is that e-commerce is very much cost effective, because the total cost that is required to run an electronic business is comparatively less as we compare it to the traditional one. And it saves a lot of time also, because we don't have to go anywhere. We can just sit at home and place an order, and we'll get that order delivered at our home without going anywhere. In case of traditional commerce, there is a face-to-face interaction between the people, between the customer and the owner. But in case of e-commerce, there is no face-to-face interaction, because all the things we are doing online. And e-commerce is providing us a universal platform for doing the business activities. But in case of traditional commerce, we don't have any platform. It depends on the personal communication only, or the face-to-face interaction only. So this was all about today's session on e-commerce. Now it's time for the important questions. That is, you have to explain how e-commerce is more better than traditional commerce, what are its advantages over the traditional one, or you have to explain the categories of e-commerce that we have already discussed, like B2B, B2C, C2C, C2B. And then you have to compare and contrast the scope and challenges of the e-commerce. That means, what is the scope and what are the various challenges that we have to face doing an e-business. So prepare all these questions. I hope this session was fruitful for you, and these questions are important from the examination point of view of also. So do prepare them also. students, thank you so much for watching. This was all about today, and in the next session we will discuss about the future or key impacts of e-commerce and what are the various obstacles for e-commerce. Thank you so much.